Hi, my name is William Orving, and I'm working as a technical artist at Epic Games. And if you followed my earlier tutorials regarding pixel streaming, you should now have something set up like this. So there's the application on the left, there's a web browser on my PC running on the right, and there should also be a small window showing my mobile phone on another network. Running it on a Chrome web browser for mobile devices. Now, you should be able to set things up if you looked at the earlier tutorials. Set the pixel streaming up in Unreal Engine, being able to package that application to run it on your PC to be able to connect and interact with it from your local network as well as other networks. Now, if you're at this step, you might have noticed that you're not able to interact with the application through your mobile phone. So in this tutorial, I will go through the two main reasons why that is, and hopefully help you set that up yourself. So one of the main reasons, and maybe the most obvious one for not being able to interact with the application through your mobile web browser, is that you don't have touch support in your application. Now it's really easy to test this in Unreal Engine without having to go through any kind of blueprints or controls or programming in the engine. And that is by going into the project settings. Now you can find the project settings under settings if you have the toolbar activated. You can find it under settings and project settings, or if you don't have the toolbar activated, you can find it under edit and project settings. Now find engine and then go under input where you will be able to find the mobile part of it. You can activate this always show touch interface to show a virtual touch in UI that will go over the application. So I will show you how that looks. And while this is loading, you can see that I'm touching the mobile phone as well, so it loads that at the same time. Now I will use my mouse to just interact with it in Unreal Engine, and you'll see that it's moved in the mobile browser as well. But if I do touch it now on the touch UI, you can see that it interacts with the camera as well. Pretty easy way of testing it, at least. Now, the second reason why you might not be able to interact or even connect with a pixel streaming server is probably because you don't have a stun or turn server set up. So what I tend to do is just go into Google, search for stun server lists, because there are actually a lot of public ones that you can find. The first one is for GitHub, a list created by ZZ Ayuni that you can just copy into your documents and use later. So while having this site up, I will just show you. Here is the signaling web server folder that we worked with on another tutorial. And while we used the start AWS signaling server back then and put our own IP as the stun server then, we will now be using this link here as a stun server instead and use our IP or public IP as the turn server. So you do the same for this one, which is called start AWS with turn signaling server. You can just double click it. It will show up as the other one and you'll see that the public IP variable is there as a stun and as a turn server. So what we can do now is you see that this is directed to the port 19302, and you can also see that it's the same port that is being used here in the document. So instead of just copying the entire of this, you can just copy the stun.l.google.com, put that into where the public IP is for the stun and use double quotes for it. And as we did before, when working on putting this up for network use, you can use your public IP for this. And I just tend to copy mine directly from Google, because I will be using that anyway, and put that in, remove the HTTP, and add double quotes. Now, if you save this, you should be able to just close it down and run the AWS return instead. And as you might see while this is loading, I have my phone on a small screen here that I will be interacting with whenever this is up. Load my website on the phone. You will see that it is running there. I will interact with my application, now running directly in the Unreal Engine. It works perfectly. You see my phone is interacting as well, and I can use the touch UI on the phone as well. So, now that we have this set up for local use as well as network, and being able to interact with it with a phone web browser as well, I would like to take the time next tutorial to show you how to customize and change the website so you're able to, for example, push buttons or interact with sliders to change the environment of your game or your application. So, see you then!